The thought of ditching glasses is alluring, but a government database of problems after surgery paints a picture of what can go wrong. Pain worse than childbirth, the worst decision of my life.
Max Burleson Cronin.
Nancy Burleson's Iraqi war veteran son killed himself in 2016. His suicide note said, "I trusted a doctor that destroyed my eyes."
No one tells you what to do the day after you bury a child.
In at least three cases, families said LASIK has caused their loved ones to take their own lives.
When did your view on LASIK begin to change?
It's cases like those that make former FDA supervisor Morris Waxler rethink his role in approving LASIK.
I got this call from patients. People were very, very upset at me because my name is all over the approval documents.
He says when he helped get LASIK approved, eye surgeons told him that surgery offered positive outcomes nearly across the board.
I was lied to. I trusted people I shouldn't have trusted. And I didn't know a lot of things that I now know.
Waxler, who'd started his own industry consulting company here in Madison, Wisconsin, decided to take on his former employer, demanding that the FDA reconsider its decision.
The problem is not so much with the surgery, but with the recovery. Dr. Waxler says even if a surgeon does everything right, a patient could suffer problems because we all heal differently. Sometimes the cuts in the eyes don't heal, or the eye becomes weak after being cut. Other times, nerves never reconnect properly.
They grow back in little whirligigs, and they just end on themselves, and they produce pain all the time.
We're just now understanding how that can occur.
LASIK supporter and ophthalmologist Dr. John Vukic agrees that healing is not an exact science, but stresses millions of lives have been improved.
The balance of good is so overwhelming for those individuals who have had LASIK that I think we have to look at that in context.
96% of patients are satisfied after surgery, he says. And he adds that researchers are trying to better understand why rarely things go wrong. Waxler wants the FDA to more prominently warn LASIK patients of the risks, including on its website.
Why do you think the FDA hasn't taken your advice?
Because they're stuck with their decision. If they make a big dramatic change in their website, the refractive surgeons and the industry are going to come down on them like glue. I mean, they're going to hit them hard.
But for Waxler, the hundreds of reports of things like post-surgery pain and double vision speak for themselves.
Some people might say there's inherent risk in any surgery, but we still proceed with it because many people are helped by it. How is it not the case here?
You got a healthy eye. This is not, they can put on glasses, they can put on contact lenses. There's a safe alternative.
You don't think it's worth it?
Absolutely not.